Hey everybody, it's the Library Lady with you tonight, and I'm just sharing a new book called Wolfie the Bunny. This is by Amy Dykman, illustrated by Zachariah O'Hora, published in 2015 by Little Brown and Company. So this is our next great book on my segment, What's the Story? Now, What's the Story was created so that you at home can get an idea of some great children's books, both picture books and chapter books, and then some ideas on what you can do with a story with your child. I am a former elementary school teacher and librarian, and I really have a passion and a heart for books. And I know a lot of you are stuck at home right now wondering, what can my child read? What can I do? And these are great, just easy, simple things that you can do to engage your reader into literacy and give them some activities that will keep them engaged. And hopefully, maybe there's some books that you haven't heard of. If you have heard of some of my books that I've been reviewing, then go ahead and listen to the part about what you can do with the book, because hopefully that will give you some good ideas and get some ideas flowing. So Wolfie the Bunny, I think, is a great picture book. I have used it in my library before, and I think the inside jacket really sums it up nicely. Families of all kinds will delight in this hilarious and sweet tale of sibling rivalry, bravery, unconditional love, and veggies. So a great little intro, and I'll read a snippet in just a second. As always, this is not a read aloud. I would love to read the whole story because it's that great, but I cannot due to copyright. And but I did reach out to Amy Dykman. I have not corresponded with her before, although I am very familiar with a lot of her books. And I must say, she was really pleasant to correspond with. And thank you so much for allowing me to share your book. So let's get started. We'll read just a snippet of the book and then give you some ideas on what you can do. So the first picture is great. We have the bunny family here. And as you can see, there's a wolf who has arrived on their doorstep. I love the illustrations. The kids usually are drawn into these. They're very colorful and just a different element than what I see typically in children's books. So fabulous illustrations. The bunny family came home to find a bundle outside their door. They peeked. They gasped. It was a baby wolf.
"He's adorable," said Mama.
"He's ours," said Papa.
"He's going to eat us all up," said Dot.
But Papa and Mama were too smitten to listen. And here you can see Dot, very apprehensive about what has arrived and quite nervous and fearful of this wolf. So one thing I would do first with reading the book, I always like to stop and engage my readers about what's going to happen. So what do you think this wolf will do? Or maybe why is the wolf there? And ask your child some questions just about this intro page. You can usually find a lot about what they're thinking, and you're usually amazed at what they come up with. One thing that you can do too before even starting the story is what we call in teacher world an anticipation guide. This is a very simple activity. You need to read the book ahead of time, and you need to write some statements down. You can do as many as you'd like, 3, 4, 5, whatever you think your reader can do. And go ahead and make some of them true and some of them false. So for example, a wolf was sitting on the sidewalk. Okay. Or Dot was very fearful of the wolf. And your child will go through and mark them, or you can read them to your child and help them mark them as yes or no, if it's going to happen in the story, true or false, whatever's easier for your child. And then at the end of the story, go back and read those statements. It's a great way to check on comprehension. What do they remember from the story? But also I like this activity because it allows them to think that, you know, I said that it was going to happen, or that was true and it wasn't. And that as readers, our prediction change as we read, and it's okay if what you thought didn't actually happen. Sometimes kids really get stuck on being right, and they want their prediction to be true, but I always stress it's okay. That's what your brain was thinking. You were engaged. You were wondering about the story, using what you knew, making connections, that type of thing. So always celebrate that with your reader at home, that if they don't have their prediction right, it's okay. All right. So those are some just reading kind of activities that you can do. Now, Dot does take a little trip to a co-op. I love the illustration of the little grocery mart she's gone to. And she uses a reusable bag. Now, Earth Day, April 22nd, is a great day to talk about Earth and reducing and reusing and recycling. And you can talk about how using a bag is so much better than the plastic bags at the store. Maybe you can get a little canvas type tote and have your child decorate and draw. Be fun to pull out and say, "Hey, this is the bag we made when we read Wolfie the Bunny," and use this next time you go to a store. or if they have to go somewhere, take this along with their little toys and items. Now, if you're feeling more of the gardening type, as bunnies love carrots, you may want to plant some carrots. I am not an expert at gardening, but you may want to plant some and see what happens, and it's fun to kind of go on that little planting adventure. Now, in that same light with science, it's sometimes fun to then research bunnies. Your child, usually animals are a hit in the nonfiction reading world for elementary kids, and so maybe look up some stories online or see what you have around your home about bunnies. You can talk about Dot versus an actual bunny. What are some different things? Like Dot wears clothes, real bunnies don't. You can also look at the features of the book. You know, a fiction book has a beginning, a middle, and an end. And you can talk about the story and what happened throughout. And then at nonfiction, they have real photographs, true facts or information, and talk a little bit about the differences. So sometimes when I read picture books, I always do like to pair it up with a nonfiction book so they can see those differences, not only in the characters, but just the general layout and premise of the book. So that's an activity that you can do. Wolfie and Dot are such cute characters. It's just fun to make. You can make these out of paper, out of a paper bag. If you're really crafty and have some fabric, I am not. So I'm more the popsicle stick kind of person, or even a spoon works great. You can use like a plastic spoon and then give them some little clothes made out of paper, fabric, whatnot, and then decorate the head part of the spoon as their face. And you can take Wolfie and Dot and kind of act out the story and do a little story reenactment. And that's a lot of fun for younger kids. One element that comes in the story is feelings and emotions. Right off the bat, we saw Dot very fearful that she was going to get eaten up. And then you can see how she kind of changes through the story. So it might be a good idea to talk, especially if there's a sibling in the home, or even just a friend. Sometimes how, if you don't have siblings, how sometimes people can be annoying and you don't want them around and they're not fun to play with and they take your toys and they get all the attention and things like that. And so talk about that and then talk about, well, what do we actually like about the person? Why are you friends with them? Or what's so great about your brother? Some people may need some prodding on that one, but make a list of great things about that sibling or that friend. And then maybe give it to them and say, hey, these are all the great things I think about you. Sometimes with siblings, it can be hard to share and to share the spotlight. So you'll see Dot kind of struggle a little bit with that. There's also a character that we'll meet later in the book that's not so nice. And so this is a good opportunity to talk about what you can do when someone is mean to you. What should you do? Talk about bullying and how does it feel when somebody is mean to you? So that's a good kind of guidance type lesson that you can have with your child. So there's another great website too that in my kind of reading to use this book in my library, readingisfundamental.com. It's the America's largest nonprofit literacy group, and they actually have some Wolfie the Bunny activities. So you can find memory, like a matching memory with some of the words and the vocabulary, a crisscross kind of activity, like word puzzle, and a word search. So you may want to find that. If you go to readingisfundamental.com, there's a library central, or literacy central up in the top right corner, and you can click that and get some different activities. Memory, you just play right online. So look around, there's lots of great resources when you Google Wolfie the Bunny, and I think you'll be excited. You can check out Amy Dykman's website, check out some of her other books, but I think it's going to be a hit. When I read this with younger kids, they always say, is there another Wolfie book, or is there another character like that? Because they really like this story, and it's just witty and funny, and the kids really enjoy it. So I highly recommend it. Check it out. Let me know what you think in the comments below about the book, and then if you have any suggestions on what you would like me to review, please leave that in the comment. And I would love it if you would click subscribe to show your appreciation for my sharing of children's literacy. So thanks so much for tuning in. We'll see you next time on What's the Story?